knees to my toes, I praise the Lord every day with my eyes and my ears, my hands and my feet. I praise the Lord every day with my mouth talks. I will praise the Lord where my feet walk. I will praise the Lord with a smile on my face. I will praise the Lord. God made all of me to praise the Lord. Yeah. From my head to my shoulders, my knees to my toes, I praise the Lord.
Teachers, all, welcome to St. George's Methodist Sunday School for this, the second day of August 2020. Today we will talk about how Jesus fed 5,000 men plus women and children with just 5 loaves of bread and 2 fish. You might ask, how can that be? Is this for real? Of course it is for real. It really did happen. Remember that with God, all things are possible. You may ask, how did he do that? This is what we'll talk about in our Sunday school lesson today. Our lesson today is by teacher Zandra Ross. Scripture reading is Matthew chapter 14 verse 20 by Ishad. Prayer by teacher Allison and Maggie. We will also have our activity. Boys and girls, know this. Only Jesus can do this. Only Jesus can turn 5 loaves and 2 fish into much to feed 5,000 plus people. So let's just sing and praise the Lord.
Praise him again and again and again and again. Dear merciful Father, we come to you today with thanksgiving for the miracles that you have performed that will teach us lessons that could pattern the way we should live. The feeding of the 5,000, dear Lord, we see that you have taken a little child's meal, which he gracefully give up to feed 5,000 persons, and it even had more. Dear Jesus, we as your children could understand the little things that you can give to us and the little things that we can do for others. It could make such a big difference, and it could have over and over and overs after we have given a little bit. Dear Lord, we thank you for this lesson that we should not hold back the little bit that we have, but we should give the little bit that we have that will make a difference, and it will make a difference bountifully. Dear Jesus, we thank you. We thank you. Amen.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, for we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from all evil. From thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
And were satisfied, and the disciples picked up 12 baskets of broken pieces that were left over.
Good morning, girls and boys, and to all joining us today. We continue to praise and worship Christ, our living Savior, and thank him for all his wonderful blessings this morning. Girls and boys, the reading this morning came from Matthew chapter 14, verses 20 to 21. And the reading was about Jesus feeding 5,000 with 5 loaves of bread and 2 fish. We will find out how we did this a little later. Right now, I would like you to go on a picnic with me. Yes, you heard me. We're going on a Sunday school picnic this morning, and I want you to help me pack our St. George's Sunday school picnic basket. So, let's go. First of all, top of my list would be sandwiches, juices, chocolate biscuits, cakes, chips, soft drinks, water, and lots of fruits. Did you put in the same as I did? Did you think the same things? Well, if you did, do you think we have enough to feed our St. George's Sunday School this morning? I believe we did. I believe we did have quite a lot inside that basket, and we can feed our Sunday school. But wait, what if our church members wanted to come along to our picnic? Would there be enough food in that basket? Or maybe if everyone in town wanted to come along to our picnic? Certainly, the food will never be enough. No way. It's impossible. But there was someone who made it possible to feed 5,000 men with women and children with 5 small loaves of bread and 2 fish. Let's listen to this miraculous story of how Jesus did this. Jesus was very tired and went into a boat to a quiet place by himself. But when the crowds heard this, they followed him on foot from the towns. When Jesus went ashore, he saw a great crowd of people, and he had compassion on them, meaning he felt very sorry for them, and he began to heal them. He healed the sick. When it was evening, the disciples came to Jesus and said, "This is a lonely place, and the day is over. Send the crowds away to go into the town to buy food." But Jesus said, "They need not go anywhere." The disciples then answered and said, "Messiah, we only have 5 loaves and 2 fish." Jesus answered them and said, "Bring them to me." He ordered the crowds to sit down. He took the loaves, looked up to heaven, and gave thanks. Then Jesus broke the loaves and gave the disciples with the fish to give to the crowds. And they all ate, 5,000 men, and there were women and children, and they were all satisfied. They were filled. And guess what? They had 12 baskets of leftover food. What a miracle indeed Jesus performed that day. This story has a wonderful message and meaning for all of us. Even if it was a long, long time ago, it holds true to us today that we must be compassionate, meaning we must feel sorry and have regards for those who need not only food, but to share God's love, to be kind to others. He wants us to follow Jesus' lead and to do the same. We can learn many things from this miracle that Jesus performed in feeding the 5,000. He asks us to use whatever we have, and he will take care of the rest. Jesus never sends people away. Jesus uses people to help others so both can be blessed. He gave thanks before the meal. Even someone who has everything can be thankful. When we give ourselves and share what we have to others, we receive his wonderful blessings and can multiply, meaning we can have much more than what we really need. Remember, Jesus did miracles then, and he can even today. Let us give ourselves and gifts to God. Jesus is mighty to save and strong to provide. Let us go to him in prayer. Father God, your son Jesus fed 5,000 with 5 small loaves and 2 fish. Accept our small prayer offering to you today, that your blessing will multiply in our lives. We praise and thank you for all that you have provided and continue to provide daily. We ask that you help us to be compassionate to others in need, like your son Jesus, and through your son Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Amen.
God, and all will see how great. is our God. How great is our God. Sing with me, how great is our God. And all will see how great is our God.
Boys and girls,
hello.
As you would have heard from teacher Sandra, Jesus took just 5 loaves and 2 fish and was able to feed 5,000 and more persons.
Wow.
Don't you think that's mind-boggling?
Yes.
Just imagine what Jesus can do for you. Didi, can you tell us some of the things Jesus can do for you?
Absolutely. When he is the great comforter, so whenever I am sad or lonely, I turn to Jesus. He's a friend to all, whom I can confide in. He is a great doctor, who I can go to for healing.
Well said.
Thank you.
This week, we are going to make a poster to hang in your rooms. You will need a picture, or you can draw your own picture of loaves and fish. You will need crayons, markers. That's just about it. Color or decorate your picture nicely. Write the words, "Little is much when God is in it." On completion, hang your poster in your room to remind you, with God, all things
are possible.
See you next week.
Bye.
And now, may the grace of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all, now and forevermore. Amen.
What's that noise? Who's crying?
I don't know. Where's it coming from, Cindy? Sounds like over there from that old songbook.
Jason, it's coming from the book.
That's silly. Books don't cry.
Well, this one does.
Maybe it's got a name. Excuse me, Mr. Songbook? Do you have a name?
Yes!
He talks! He really talks!
Well, What's your name?
Salty.
Salty, why are you crying?
Because nobody'll sing my music. They just tossed me off in the corner and they forgot all about me.
We'll sing your music.
Yeah, we'll sing your songs, won't we?
Yeah.
But I'm a kid's songbook. I need kids to sing my song.
We're kids.
You are?
Yeah, but how do we start?
Well, this might sound silly, but first you need to think happy thoughts about Jesus.
Happy thoughts? About Jesus?
Yeah, like he's your Lord and Savior, and he loves you so very much.
He loves me?
Yeah, he loves you.
He loves me, yeah.
We're gonna sing.
You're doing it.
Sing.
You're doing it.
We're gonna sing.